This video will help you to get to know the technical details about retroreflectance, to successfully use the Mini, be in the field or in the laboratory. It is recommended to calibrate every day before work. Always use the reference that comes with the product. Check the ceramic. It must be clean and free of marks and broken spots. Place the instrument on the base. Access the main menu and select the option calibration. Then follow the instructions on the screen. Whenever this message pops up on the screen, it is time to calibrate the instrument. A common question: where is the Mini measurement area? What is its length? Measurements are taken in front of the instrument, so you need about half a meter ahead for correct measurements. Do not place it too close from the end of the marking line. In case of doubt, turn off the lights and check whether the illuminated area matches the sample. Beware of the surface where you work with the Mini. A traditional device covers the entire measurement area and makes it impossible to see the evaluated area. Knowing where you are measuring is very important. Mini, on the other side, lets you see and access the spot where you are measuring. Pay attention to the instrument position. Keep it aligned with the line. Always take measurements directed to the flow of the vehicles. With the Mini, the measurement area is totally accessible. That allows you to take more precise performance tests, such as wet and rain tests. A common question is whether Mini suffers any interference from external light. Mini is immune to any external light interference, be it the sun or artificial lights, thanks to its coated light system. How many measurements should we take on the road? Is one spot enough? As you know, road markings aren't uniform. A minimum of 10 measurements is recommended. Create a new log and take space measurements to obtain an average. If the result is too low, check for interferences like a small rock, gravels, or unevenness on the surface. Mini has optical arrangement B. This brings great stability in case of small inclinations, which are inevitable in the fieldwork. Hold the trigger to delete this measurement and try another position, free of interferences. The entrance angle is only 1.24 degrees. To implement CEN 30 meter geometry, the Mini, as any retroreflectometer, needs a plane surface. What if it's there profile markings? No problem. Mini works with up to 15 millimeters elevations. Working with road markings, test panels in the lab demand special care. In case of test panels, the measurement area may not match the sample length, which causes errors. Mini must be placed on the same level as the measured surface in order to obtain correct results. You can add supporting blades to help leveling. Do not place the Mini on a higher or lower surface. Leveling is fundamental. In case of doubt, turn off the lights and check whether the illuminated area matches the sample. Beware of the surface where you work with the Mini. Small irregularities, gravels, and small rocks may affect the result. When measuring test panels, always work on a plain and rigid surface, preferably a polished stone or a workbench. Measuring marking tapes requires attention. An unrolled marking tape presents irregularities and undulations that may block the reading light. Traditional big and heavy equipment must be placed over the material to be measured. The weight of the product presses and aligns the tape on the surface. That does not happen with Mini, whose reading area is external. No weight is placed on the measuring area. For this reason, any deformation, warps on the edges, or unevenness on the surface can affect the results. Whenever you can, remove the liner and stick the tape over the surface. If you have any questions, leave us a comment. Thank you for watching.